All right, on this edition of Big D Broadcast Exchange, we're going to recondition a Studer A727 CD player. We're going to put a new display lamp in it. I'm going to put some rubber O-rings on the pulleys for the drawer that slides out. All right, the drawer has some little rubber O-rings, and I've got like three left in my inventory. These are the original Studer O-rings that go on the pulley that the drawer slides out on. So to put new ones of those on, you have to take, of course, the faceplate off, which I'm doing anyway to change out the lamp. Then I pull off this metal part here. There's two screws here, like four across the bottom. Then to get that pulley off, there's a little snap ring you have to take off right here. Then you take a little box end or open end wrench, loosen up the nuts on the top right here, and then you can lift up. That gives it some play, and you can lift up here and pull out this pulley here right here, and it has the O-ring on it, so you can see how the O-ring's cracked right here and missing. So it's when you're rolling, it kind of clunk 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 as it goes along. All this does is it just acts as a rubber tire for it to slide on. So I'm going to take this old one off. It's dry rotted or something, and put the new O-ring on like this. Inspect the pulley, make sure it's clean, and install it in reverse order the way I took it off. So on this, faceplate back in. All right, now I'm going to work on the display next. So let's move this out of the way. And I'm going to change out the display, make sure there's nothing on your workbench to scratch it. So you want to pop out the display like so. The screwdriver. Just kind of pry these little wings out, and it should pop right out. Set that aside. This has a brand new crystal, but I do have, looks like a couple of these in stock. There's the old one that used to be on this. So this is in good shape. We're going to leave that. So put it face down on the carpet. Now I'm going to get a smaller screwdriver, take off the circuit board. So what you want to do, the original has the loops here. You just cut that right there and cut that side, and then take your tweezers, or you can use your cutters if you're good. Kind of pull that out. Let's see if I can get to it. And you just slide it out that way. And that's the old lamp. It's going to look like that, silver on the back and that way in front. Now, you take your solder sucker. All right, you want to flip this thing over after you remove the old one. And use a solder sucker to pull out the leads from the other lamp. Should suck them right out. Make sure you clean them up so you can look through there and see a pretty large size opening in for the holes. Then you'll grab your new one. The new ones I sell from Big D Broadcast Exchange at bigdmc.com. Will look like this with flat layout. So what you'll need to do is bend a little loop in it, and also bend 90 degrees as it's facing you. Bend a 90 degree angle like that. Let's see if you can see it against this white background. There's like a 90 right there, you can see it, 90 degree in there. So you take the display facing you, make sure it's clean, leave the white side facing towards the display, and slide it in. And then as you slide it in, you'll need to take some tweezers and bend a loop in it and put these in the holes. And you'll have to make a little adjustment to kind of push it in there, make sure it goes all the way in so you can't see any white edge sticking out there. And then with those leads sticking out, you can re-solder.
And make sure you have good connection there.
So that's all there is to it. And you just put it back in the way you took it out. There's the old one. There's the new one. And put it in like so.
And again, line the screws up.
That's all there is to it. Snug those up, inspect everything, make sure it's clean. Lay this face down on a clean workbench, unlike mine. And let's just cock it at an angle. Snaps back in place. You're supposed to put a little glue here and here. Not really necessary. So there it is, ready to install back into the CD player. All right, this is an old Studer bulletin that was back in Nashville. They used to give out these little extra prints that would tell you what to change this resistor to. If your lamp is dim, after you replace the light and you want it brighter, you might check R52, which is right here. And a lot of people change those out. R52 is supposed to be 4.7 to 5.6K. And a lot of people put in a value of a 10K resistor that would make the lamp dimmer and it would extend its life. So you want to make sure that that stock hadn't been changed out to something that will cause it to be dim. Since lamps are so cheap now, they used to be $80 for an original Studer lamp that came from Germany. So now that I have these for like $19 each plus shipping, I see no reason in to run a dull lamp the whole time. You put a new one in, you want it to be bright like it was when it was new. So double check R52 resistor, which is located here. Make sure it is 4.7 to 5.6K. They're easy to take out. Just four screws that dumps off the bottom with a little connector. That's what's great about the Studers. They're easy to work on. And these things pretty much last forever. They got a real long laser beam in here, as you can see. It swings on a pendulum. If those get out of alignment, you have to send it off to somebody else that knows what they're doing, because I've done it a long time ago, but I had special CDs that were required to do that, and I no longer have those. I think the set of those were like over $100 at the time I got them. But I no longer work for the company that has those. They probably threw them out, which is a sad part. It's a very lengthy process. It takes a lot of test equipment and a lot of knowledge to do that. So the thing that usually goes wrong with them, they'll stay in alignment. It's this spindle here that spins the CD on. That's the first thing to go out. There's a little plastic bearing right here on the bottom of that, and that gets worn out easy, and as far as I know, I haven't found a replacement for those yet. All right, real quick, what we do is this spindle here. You take these two screws out here, this whole U-shaped bracket comes off. Then you there's a nut behind that with a washer, take that off. Then this whole magnetic motor part will slide out. Then this spindle shaft comes out. This spindle shaft needs to be polished and removed of all of its oil. I use a motor cleaner to remove all the oil. Then I put a drop of oil on this little chamois. I use the pin synthetic fishing reel oil. It's good for like small parts like this. Then I'll just rub the shaft on that pad. So you want very little oil. You don't want to put drops of oil or anything like that, because it'll gum it up and make it run slower. This thing has to have no friction at all. So I've got it reinstalled with all that. If this eye is dirty, you'll want to take a microfiber cloth and probably just lightly rub it. Sometimes you can use a pad like this with Kodak lens cleaner on it. And I don't like to use any liquid. I just rub it with a microfiber cloth. Don't press down hard, just rub across it till it looks clean. This alignment, don't want to mess with that.
Okay, I'm going to get a Torx wrench that fits that bearing right there. So it fits, and we're going to lay this thing flat and let it hang off the edge of the workbench.
And you first plug it in after it's been unplugged, and the first time you turn it on will give you the
firmware number. So it's
40. Okay, once you got it all back together, mostly, you can set your bearing underneath. You let a little bit of the machine hang over the edge. Put in a CD. Here's one that I know is finicky, going to Lightfoot, so see if it starts. And it starts just fine. So I'm going to turn the bearing clockwise till it goes out, and then turn it back again till it comes back on. Turn it counterclockwise. So I want to put, I can kind of tell when I turn it clockwise it goes off, turn it counterclockwise it goes out. So I kind of put it in between and then keep trying different CDs. And if you find one that doesn't work, then you have to kind of just fine tune it. But looks like this thing's handling just about everything I can throw at it. Let's try it.
All right, let's give it a try here, see what it'll do. Spins up just fine. Jumps ahead, 14. New display lamp. And it's ready to sell. The only flaws are the scratches along here from taking it in and out of rack, and I smacked it with my diamond ring a few times and put dimples from the diamonds all in here. You can't tell from the video, but I'll drop in a good shot of it. And that's it. Other than that, it works fine. I put every kind of CD I've got into it, trying to get it to fail, and it doesn't. I'm sure, though, if it sets for a long time and motor sets, it tends to not spin up as easy as it does if you just use it every day. So there it is, Studer
A727. All right, it's played just about everything I've thrown at it. Just got done refurbishing the Studer A727 CD player. In my opinion, one of the best sounding CD players ever made. So hope you enjoyed this, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.